transformation of host cells. Transformation process allows a bacterium to take up genes from its surrounding environment. That is, transformation involves the direct uptake of fragments of DNA by a recipient cell and the acquisition of new genetic characteristics. There are two major parameters involved in efficiently transforming of a host. The first is a method used to induce competence for transformation. The second is the genetic constitution of the host strain of the organism being transformed. Competent cells are capable of taking up DNA from their environment and expressing DNA as functional proteins. If a bacterium is said to be competent, it has to maintain a physiological state in which it can take up the donor DNA. Calcium chloride treatment is one of the best methods for the preparation of competent cells. In the process of transformation, the competent cells are incubated with the DNA in ice. Then it is placed in a water bath at 42 degrees Celsius and subsequently plunged in ice. This process takes up the DNA into the bacterial cell. Then it is placed in an agar plate containing appropriate antibiotic. The presence of an antibiotic marker on the plasmid allows rapid screening of successful transformants. Blue-white selection, that is alpha complementation, can be used to differentiate between transformants and non-transformants. Materials required: ice box, competent cells, DNA, LB broth, IPTG, XGAL, empty microfuge tube, Petri plate, spreading rod in ethanol, laminar airflow, floater, water bath, incubator, micropipettes, tips. Procedure: arrange all the required materials in the laminar airflow and flame the Bunsen burner. Insert a fresh micropipette tip into 1000 microliter micropipette and transfer 200 microliter of competent cells into an empty microfuge tube taken from the ice box. Place the tube back in the ice box. Take 10 microliter micropipette, insert a fresh micropipette tip into it, and transfer 10 microliter of DNA to this microfuge tube. Store the tube in ice for 30 minutes. Now place the tube in a floater and keep it in water bath at 42 degrees Celsius for 95 seconds. Take out the tube from the water bath and place it back in the ice box for 2 minutes. Now insert a fresh micropipette tip into the 1000 microliter micropipette and transfer 800 microliter of LB broth from the conical flask to the tube. Place the tube in a floater and keep it in water bath at 37 degrees Celsius for 45 minutes. After 45 minutes, take the tube from the water bath and place it back in the ice box. Switch off the light in the laminar airflow. Now take the 100 microliter micropipette, insert a fresh micropipette tip and transfer 40 microliter of XGAL into a Petri plate. Take the 10 microliter micropipette, insert a fresh micropipette tip and transfer 7 microliter of IPTG into the same Petri plate. Insert a fresh micropipette tip into the 1000 microliter micropipette and transfer 200 microliter of solution containing competent cells, DNA, LB broth to the same Petri plate. Now dip the spreading rod in ethanol and burn it in flame. Allow to cool it for some time. Using this rod, spread the solution in the Petri plate evenly. After spreading the solution, close the Petri plate. Ensure that the process of adding and spreading the solution in the Petri plate do not take too much time. Finally, place the Petri plate in the incubator for 12 to 16 hours. Observations: after 12 to 16 hours, on removing the Petri plate from the incubator, we can see blue and white colonies in the Petri plate.